Hello students, again welcome to our online teaching classes of BPS Balangir. Today we are going to discuss a new subject, not new chapter only, new subject for you, because you are the students of class 9 now. Up to class 8 you have not learned the subject economics. You have learned history, political science and geography, not economics. So you must be feeling nervous to some extent. I hope that you must be feeling nervous to some extent. But my dear students, don't feel nervous. It is very exciting. It is very exciting and very interesting also. And this chapter, this subject will increase your knowledge of your. This chapter will increase the dimension of your knowledge. You will be very happy with them, because it will increase your knowledge about the production, consumption, and transfer of wealth. Okay, so now you have already learned. So what is economics? So economics is a subject, it is the branch of knowledge about the production, consumption and transfer of wealth. It is a branch of knowledge about the production, consumption and transfer of wealth. This is knowledge economics. So economics is a very interesting chapter, and it will enhance your knowledge about the production, consumption and transfer of wealth from one head to another, from one person to another, from one country to another, everything. This is known as economics. Okay? So who founded this economics? Who is the father of economics? Adam Smith, the father of economics. Adam Smith is the father of economics. Okay, so let us start the very first chapter of this interesting subject, that is economics. The story of village Palampur. The story of village Palampur, from the name of the chapter, you must be feeling something strange in your mind. I hope that. The story of village Palampur and it is economics. How it is related? Very strange. Let us say, actually, the story of village Palampur, this Palampur village, it is an imaginary village. It is not fact. It is an hypothetical village. In order to make us clear about the different process of production, different factors of production, how the production of different goods and services is carried out, we will come to know after reading this chapter. So the main motto of this chapter is to make us clear about the different process, different concepts relating to production. And this is village Palampur. Palampur village is an hypothetical village. What sorts of economic activities was going on there? Let us see one by one. So here, farming is the main economic activity. Farming is the main economic activity in the village Palampur. It is an imaginary village. It is a hypothetical village. Whereas several other activities, such as besides this farming, other non-farm activities were also going on. Several such as small-scale manufacturing, dairy, transport, all these activities were carried on in a limited scale. These production activities need various types of resources. Production, it doesn't happen so easily. It is very complex method. It requires this production. This production requires very different things, like various types of resources. For example, natural resources, man-made items, natural resources, land, water, air, etc. Man-made items, different machines and tools also. And human efforts, human labors also, human's knowledge, all these things, money also. So all these are required for the production of any goods and services. As we read through the story of Palampur, we will learn how various resources combine to produce the desired goods and services in the village. So in this chapter, after reading this chapter clearly, we will be able to know, we will come to know about the different process of production, what factors are required for the process of production, in order to produce something, we will come to know. This is about your overview. Then here another thing is there is a Palampur. So what is the, in the very beginning, we will come to know about the location of village Palampur. Location of the village Palampur. What sorts of facilities were available there? We will come to know. Palampur is well connected with the neighboring villages and towns. Palampur was such a village. It was located in such a place there. It is well connected with neighboring villages and small towns also, and different towns. Raiganj is a big village. Palampur. This is village Palampur, and just 3 kilometers away from it, a big village is located. It is Sahapur, Raiganj. And here, to some extent, a little distance more, there is a small town, but this is Sahapur. And all sorts of good roads, all weather roads were available there. This was the location of the village Palampur. So Palampur has been located in a place from where a big village was located, which is 3 kilometers away from there. And a small town is also located from there, just a little distance from Palampur. That is the name of the village that was located, big village Raiganj. And the name of the small town, it was Sahapur. Many kinds of transports are visible on this. Many kinds of transport facilities were available, like the bullock carts, that is starting from bullock carts, tongas, bogies, the wooden cart drawn by different buffaloes, loaded with jaggery, good. And other commodities to motor vehicles like motorcycles, jeep, tractors and trucks, all these means of transportation facilities were available in village Palampur. This village has about, then we will, secondly, after the location, then we will come to know about the structure of the village, what type of families, how many families were living in village Palampur. So here, structure of the village has about 400 total, 400 the structure. Structure of the village, the total number of families was 450 families. So as many as 450 families were living in village Palampur, and out of these, the 80 upper caste families had won maximum or majority land area. They were rich people. These 80 upper caste people are rich people. They had won majority areas of land holdings with them. And the total, out of the total 450 families, one third of 450, that is 150 families were SC people, matlab scheduled caste. So they were landless also. They were Dalit people, they were landless, they were leading not very good lives. So most of the house and their houses were made up of straw and mud. These landless people who constitute are the scheduled caste, who constitute one third of the total families of the village Malampur, and their number was 150 families. Their houses were made up of kacha houses, that is made up of straw and mud. Most of the houses were electric connection. Most of the houses in village Palampur have electric connection. You know, nowadays electricity plays a very important role in every sphere of our life, that is for our consumption, that is production, our agriculture, our manufacturing, small industry, everything. So here, most of the houses in village Palampur have good electric connections. Electricity powers all the tube wells in the fields and is used in Malampur. How was electricity helpful in village Palampur? Here we will discuss. How was electricity was helpful in village Palampur? Electricity was very helpful in village Palampur. That means they were using tube wells, bore wells, in order to water their large fields for agriculture. And electricity was also used for small manufacturing units. There is all these things. And Palampur has to, for on the other hand, this is electricity. On the other hand, for educational level, what sorts of educational facilities were there? Or for education, what sorts of facilities were available in village Palampur for educational level or for the educational development, there are two primary schools and one high school. Two primary schools, one high schools, two primary schools and one high schools are available for educational facilities. In order to provide educational facilities in village Malampur, there are two primary schools and one high school. There is a primary health centers run by the government and one private dispensary where the Sikhs are treated. And for healthcare facilities, what sorts of things are available for healthcare facilities to provide better healthcare facilities to the village, to the people of village Palampur? There is a primary health center, that is PHC, primary health center. There is one primary health centers and one private dispensary. One private dispensary also where the sick people were treated. Okay. So after discussing about the village Palampur, there is available about its from its location, thereafter from its structure, thereafter from its educational level, thereafter from its health status and health care facilities, we will come to know that. So Palampur is a definitely well developed village. Okay, so in this situation, the description above shows that Palampur has fairly well developed system of roads, transport, electricity, irrigation facilities, schools, and healthcare facilities. So we will come to from these factors we come to know that village Palampur is a well developed village, undoubtedly. The story of Palampur is an imaginary village which takes through the different types of production activities in the village. So, but we'll come to know what sorts of production activities were going on there in villages across India. Farming, you know, India is an agricultural country, and farming is the main production activity across almost all the villages of our country. Okay, so the other production activities referred to as non-farm activities includes also besides. You know that from the very beginning I have told that farming is the main activity, main economic activity in village Palampur. Besides this farming, other non-farm activities are also, non-farming activities are also going on there. Okay, so here we shall take a different, it includes small manufacturing, transport, shopkeeping, all these activities are also non-farm activities. We will come to know by and by which farming activities are going on, which non-farm activities are going on. We will come to know. Just before we will discuss a few general things. We will discuss about a few general things of production. So here, so here, let us see first organization of production. Organization of production. How production organized? Most important points, organization of production or how production is organized, we will come to know. The main one thing, the aim of production is to produce the goods and services that we want. The aim of production is to produce the goods demanded by the human beings, demanded by us. So, considering the demands of the people or every industry, every manufacturing units, they manufacture such type of, or they produce such type of goods as demanded by us. So there are four requirements for production. First, the four requirements for production, they are, first of all, land, number two, labor, number three, physical capital, number four, human capital. These are known as the four factors of production: land, labor, physical capital, and human capital. If you want to produce something, we must require all these four factors. Those are land, labor, physical capital, and human capital. So let us see what, let us discuss one by one everything. The first requirement is land. The first requirement is land. And the land, other, the first requirement is land and other natural resources. Other natural resources such as water, forest, mineral. So besides land, we also require other natural resources, water, air, and minerals to produce something. The second requirement, that is, so if we have available land, air, water, minerals, everything, it is not sufficient to produce. So we need another more, that is labor, that is the most important part. The second requirement is labor, that is people who will do the work. Who will carry on this work? Actually, the people will do this work. Some production activities require highly skilled or educated workers. Some production activity requires highly educated workers to perform the necessary tasks like engineering works or others. And some other activities require workers who can do manual works. Less skilled persons or uneducated or uneducated workers also. For example, somewhere working, somewhere a building construction is going on. So to lift the bricks or other materials, building materials from the bottom to top, it requires unskilled labor, those who are physically fit. It doesn't require strong, it doesn't require the educated labor. Okay, so the second in this way, so each worker is providing the labor necessary for production. So the second factor of production is labor. And the third factor of production, that is the physical capital, the third factors of production, that is the physical capital. Again, it is a, so the, what is the physical capital? The variety of inputs required at every stage during production. The variety of inputs. What does it mean here? Inputs. Here, inputs means, ideas and advices. Physical capital here inputs implies that, you know, it inputs means we will come to, we will suppose it, ideas and advices. The third requirement, that is the physical capital, it is the variety of inputs, that is the different ideas, advices, etc. required at every stage during production. It requires different ideas, knowledge, skills at every stage of production. What are the items that come under physical capital? Let us see the after. What are the different items that come under physical capital? Again, this physical capital is of two types. One is the fixed capital. And second one is working capital. The third factor of production, that is physical capital, it requires different ideas and advices during the process of production. And again, this physical capital is subdivided into two parts, or includes two parts, two things, that is one is fixed capital, another is working capital. So what is fixed capital? First, tools, machines, buildings. Tools, machines, buildings range from very simple tools such as farmer's plow, very, very simple tool, to sophisticated. Sophisticated means developed. Sophisticated means developed. So from the simple tools like plow, farmer's plow, to the developed or sophisticated machineries or machines such as generators, turbines, computers, etc. So tools, machines, buildings can be used in production for over many years. These tools, building, machines can be used for many years, over many years. And they are called fixed capital. So they are called, as they can be used for many years, like building, machinery, computers, generators, these are known as fixed capital. And on the other hand, working capital. What is working capital? Raw materials can also, during our raw materials play a very important role from which the things are made. So raw materials and money in hand. Raw materials and money in hand are also important factors. Production requires a variety of raw materials such as the yarn. For example, raw materials. What is raw materials? For example, a weaver is there, he is weaving a cloth. His raw materials will be yarn or thread. From thread, he will prepare the cloth. So, your thread is the raw materials for a weaver. On the other hand, there is a potter. For a potter, the raw materials will be clay. From the clay, he will prepare the pots. He will make the pots. So raw materials are urgently necessary for production. Secondly, raw materials and money in hand are, again, also, some money is always required. For example, production is going on, or a building production or a building construction is going on. In the meantime, or during the process of production, some urgent requirements takes place, which it needs or which it requires money. So money in hand is also coming under working capital. So from this discussion, we are clear that raw materials and money in hand are known as working capital. and they can be used only once, they cannot be twice. So this is, these are the physical capital, and the last one is, that is the human capital. That is the most important factors of production, that is the human capital. There is fourth requirement, and we need knowledge and enterprise. We need knowledge and enterprise. Enterprise, you know, a place where everything is combined to produce something, factory. So we need knowledge and enterprise to be able to put together land, labor, and physical capital and produce the required output, either to use for ourselves or to sell in the market. This is known as human capital. Or these days, it is known as human capital. Okay? So every production is organized by combining. Every production is organized by combining land, labor, physical capital, and human capital, which are known as the factors of production. Okay? Every production is organized by combining land, labor, physical capital, and human capital, which are known as core factors of production or only factors of production. Okay? So after this, as we read through the story of Palampur, we will learn more about these three factors in others and human capital. We will also read about the human capital or human resource in other chapters. And thereafter we will discuss again farming activities and non-farm activities. First, which farming activities in village Palampur. Thereafter, we will read also non-farm activities in village Palampur gradually. Thank you this much today. But before I end my class, I am taking you some points, important few, here is an important question. That is, how do you know that village Palampur? Some important questions. First, how do you know that Palampur was a well-developed village? One. Secondly, how the families were divided, how the condition of the families were divided in village Palampur? Or thirdly, what are the different factors of production? What is the difference between fixed capital and working capital? All these are some important questions, whatever we discussed from this. Thank you. Again, I will come to you with this chapter in the next class. Thank you.